Welcome again to another session concerning directs and differentiation. So today we're going to deal with different questions concerning the second subtopic which we call variation. And this is from three topics. So let us see the question number one. Our question number one is stated that. Question number one. A. P varies directly as V and inversely as the square root of R. Given that P is equal to 180 when R is equal to 25 and V is equal to 9. Find P where V is equal to 60 and R is equal to 36. But question number one B. If V varies directly as the square root of the square of X and inversely as Y, and if V is equal to 18 where X is equal to 3 and Y is equal to 4, then find V where X is equal to 5 and Y is equal to 2. Now we start to write the writing solution. After writing the writing solution, here we have two concepts. Once somebody tell you certain value direct or value direct proportion, mean that you're going to use this sign which is called alpha, which is direct or sign of proportionality. But once somebody tell you maybe P is inversely, we put 1 over that variable. So now we're going to know two concepts. When somebody tell you P var direct to V, it looks like this. But when somebody tell you V var inversely proportion, means that you take 1, then you divide by like V. So now let us start to solve our question. First of all, question, write the number of the question, then write the letter which is A. Then we start. Read the question, please. P varies directly as V. P varies directly as V. But we know, when we say P varies directly, we are going to use this symbol, this one. So now we start writing P varies directly to V. Here. Keep on reading the questions. And inversely as the square root of R. And inversely. When I say inversely, means we put 1 over that variable. And inversely as the square root of R. This we call square root. This we call square root. But, sorry. Here, square root and inversely as. When you say inversely, means we put 1 over. That is inversely. What as the square root of R, as the square root of R this way. So what you're going to do now? Here we have alpha, we have alpha. We combine it. So now, we take on a single proportionality sign, which will be equal to P, is inversely proportions, or is directly proportion of values V, then times V, 1 out of square root of R. Therefore, what you're going to do now? Here, take V times 1, you get P is direct proportion to V out of the square root of R. But now we are going to remove this proportionality sign. Once you want to remove the proportionality sign, we put or we insert equal sign, we see K. We put equal sign, we see K. Here. So what? Okay, now here, we are going to remove this proportionality sign and we introduce equal sign with K. So now, to say that, P, instead of writing this proportionality sign, we introduce equal sign with K. But remember that in front of this proportionality sign, there is V over square root of R. So right here, we multiply by V out of square root of R. Therefore, once we see any number, which it is standard, we see it is divisible by 1. So here, we are going to divide by 1. When we divide by 1 here, we take K times V, we get P, now is equal to KV over square root of R. But once, because this K is constant, but the value of P we have, and the R we have. So what are we going to do now? We are supposed to find the value of this constant. In order to get the value of this constant, we are supposed to multiply by the square root of R, both sides by the square root of R. This is the square root of R and the square root of R will cancel. So we have to use P times square root of R, or square root of R times P. So now P times square root of R, this will be equal to here. We remain with K times P. So now we are going to find the value of constant. What are we going to do now? We are going to divide by V, both sides by V. So V and V will cancel. So we remain with is P times square root of R over V. This is equal to K. But this one is equal to somebody writing like this way. We can write it, we can start to write this K. So now K, this is equal to P times square root of R then over V. So now, okay, now start to search the value of P, the value of R and the value of V we have from our question. So now, we say K from here, K is equal to the value of P we have. The value of P here is 180. So we write, where does P we set this one? Here. So now we take its value, which is 180. Then we multiply by the square root of R. Square root of R, but the value of R we have, which is 25. So we write the square root of R. Remember, R is found within the square, all at the sign. So we put in the value of R, which is 25 within a room here. So now we divide by this one. V. What is the value of V? The value of V we have, which is 9. This one. So we write here, we divide by 9. So that's what we're going to do now. We started to simplify. When by 9 is 1. Here by 9 we get 20. So, but you know, the square root of 25 is equal to 5. So now K is equal to, we take 20, then we times the square root of 25 is 5. Now find the product of it. So the K now you get 100. So this is the value of constant. This is the value of what? This is the value of constant. Okay, now we have obtained the value of constant. So what are we going to do now? We are going to use this constant so as to find the required value. The our required value is we are required to determine the value of B. So what are we going to do now? From our initial formula, which is let V, K, square root of R, and V. So now P from here. P is by direct as V and inversely as the square root of R. We know. If we remember this equation, times square root of R, P divided by V, yes, times V, then divided by square root of R. Therefore, P is equal to K times V over the square root of R. So now, in order to determine the value of P, we start to insert the value. Constant we have, which is 100, we press here 100. Then, we have also V. What is our V? Our next V is 6. And in the square root of 1, what is here? Is 36. Then we insert there. So now, P, this is equal to K. What is our K? Our K is 100. So here we put in 100. Then we multiply here. V. What is V? You are going to see the second value after the already defined. So you're not allowed to use this value of V. You are supposed to use this value of V. When you are going to obtain the value of P. So P now is 6, so we multiply here by 6. Then we divide by square root of R. What is our R? The value of R is 36. So now here we write 36. But you know the square root of 36 is equal to 6. So now P this is equal to 100, then times 6, then we divide by the square root of 36 is 6. Get 6, then we simplify. 6 and 6 will cancel. So maybe we see 100. So the value of P now, the value of P, this is equal to 100. So now let us see that question, but in vague. Here, right in vague. Then the solution is look like this one. So now, start to read the question. Our question said that if we y is directed as the square root of x and inversely as y. And if v is equal to 18, where x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4, then find v, where x is equal to 5 and y is equal to 2. So let's write from here one. If your v is equal in a maximum, a moja kwa moja, now square your x. Lakini kutuambia inakuwa tena na kinyume chake cha y. Akatuambia ikiwa v ni 18 wakati x ni 3 na y ni 4, je, tafuta thamani ya v. Ikiwa x ni sawa na 5 and y ni sawa na 2. So what are you going to do now? First of all, just write the first letter, which is v. So you start writing here v. Then keep on reading the question. Our question keep on stating that v varies directly. We know the symbol, which is the sign or the direct proportion of the value, which is varies directly. We look like this one, or it looks like this one, which is varies directly proportion. But discipline, valid directly as the square of x, as the square of x. So right here, the square of x. This is the square of x. And inversely as y. When you say inversely, means we are going to write the computational sign, but according to the word inversely, we put it 1 over. But inversely as y, EV. Y. So after that, what are you going to do? We know that. We have computational sign, we have computational sign. We are going to combine it into, we are going to use only a single computational sign, which will be equal to V is directly proportional to x squared, then times 1 out of y. This is multiplication. So now, we find the product of x squared times 1. We get V now is directly proportional to x squared over y. But now, what are you going to do now? We are going to remove this proportional sign by introducing cosine BCK. By introducing cosine BCK. So now, we think of V is equal to, instead of writing proportional sign, we introduce cosine BCK. Then we multiply it. But after the proportional sign, there's x squared over y. So now we multiply by x squared over y. Now, any number which is standalone means it is divisible by 1 according to mathematical jargon or concept. So we press here 1. Therefore, what you're going to do now is that V is equal to find the product of kx squared, get kx squared over y. Then, here, V, we have the value of y, we have the value of x, we have the value of y. So what you're going to do now, here, we are going to find or to times the constant k. What you're going to do now, so to get to the value of k, we are going to multiply by y both sides. By y both sides. Therefore, y and y will cancel. So it means y times v get v, y or y, b. This is equal to k and x squared. Remember that we are trying to find the value of constant. What are you going to do? We are supposed to divide by x squared both sides. This one, x squared and x squared will cancel. So it means k, this is equal to v, y over x squared. Now we start to insert our values. Now, okay, this is equal to value. The value of V we have. Back to the question. The value of V is 18. So we are going to write 18 versus V here. But here we write 18. Then we multiply by Y. What is the value of Y? The value of Y is 4. So we write here 4. Then we divide by X squared. What is the value of X squared? The value of X is 3. But when we square it, we get 9. So 3 squared. 3 squared. 3 squared. Now let us proceed. So, okay, this is equal to 18 times 4, then divide by 3 squared. Once you say 3 squared, this is equal to 9, so here we divide by 9. Then you start to simplify it. When you simplify here by 3, we get 3. We simplify by 3, we get 6. Then when you find the product of 6 times 4, 6 and 4, we get k now, this is equal to 6 times 4, you get 24, then divide by 3. When you find the division here, or the answer is equal to k, is equal to 8. So this is the value of k. But we are not required to determine the value of k. We are going to determine the value of v. But you are going to use this constant source to determine the value of v. So now we are going to use this is the value of k, source to determine the value of v. But before, let us back to the question which you have been delivered here. Our question is V, it relates with V, X squared, and Y. So now, we say from V, this is equal to K times X squared, because this is by the property of the square of X. X squared. Then we divide by y, if you remember that question. If you remember this equation, which connects v, x squared, and y. So we are going to use this equation again. Show us to get the value of v. How we can get the value of v? We can get the value of v by inserting its value. K we have, which is 8. So we write 8 versus k here. So we write 8, then times x. You not have to use the value of x before, since they already find it. If you have already obtained the constant, you not have to use these values, please. So now we are going to use the value after they already find it here. But the next one I'm going to use here, so it's determining the value of V. So now x is 5. So here there's x squared. So we take the value of x right here. 5 then we square here. We divide by the value of y. What is the value of y? The value of y is 2. Then we write here 2. Then we divide here by 1. Here is by 4. So that V is equal to 4 times x squared. When you say x squared, this is equal to 25. When you find the product, you repeat the answer of the value of the answer of V. So now the value of V, this is equal to 100. This will be the answer. Yes, let us do the second question. The second question says that if y squared divides directly as x minus 1, what is the true value which is maybe separated by any operation? You let this one to be together. And inversely, x plus b, this one. If x is equal to 2, d is equal to 4, and y is equal to 1, then finding x where y is equal to 2 and d is equal to 1. So now, first of all, you're going to write the solution. After x is the right solution, then it's time to critically read the question again. Our question says that if y squared, like this, y squared, then values directly, like this is directly proportional to sine. Directly as x minus 1. Write the rule of this one. X minus 1. Then you put in brackets. And inversely. When someone says inversely, means write this one. Then you put 1 here. Divide by. The next variable will be 1 over. That is because of the word inversely. Like here. Inversely as this one. So we are going to write in this one. The whole one. X plus D, we put in brackets. Then we are going to combine this proportional sign. When we are combining the proportional sign, we get that y square, this is directly to x minus 1. Then times 1, this is times multiplication to x plus D. But we know here we are going to remove the proportional sign. How can we remove the proportional sign? We are going to introduce the equal sign with the k. So now, y squared, this is equal to k. Where this equal sign with k come from? By removing this proportional sign. So now we use x minus 1, this one. X minus 1, then we multiply by y of x plus d. We multiply by 1 x plus d. But we know any number which is standing along this is divisible by 1. So you put here 1 and here you put 1. Then you find the product of this one. So the y squared this is equal to k, then brackets x minus 1, then times 1. So when you multiply by 1 here, you get k bracket x minus 1, like this one. Then we divide by, take 1 times 1 times x plus d. So that x plus d. But now, once you have been given the value, before since they were defined, this value enable for you or help you to determine the value of constants. So now, your aim is just to find or determine the value of constants. How can you determine the value of constants? We are supposed to make it the subject it. So now we multiply by x plus b both side. X plus b both side. Then this x plus b will cancel. So we make this x plus b this side times y squared this one. This is equal to k bracket x minus 1. So what you are going to do now so to get the value of k? We are supposed to divide by x minus 1 both side. X minus 1 both sides. Then x minus 1 will cancel. So when we scale, k now this is equal to, we take this one, x plus b times y squared, then we divide that. We divide by x minus 1 here. X minus 1. Therefore, apart from that, we are going to insert the value of the different variables. For example, here, k is equal to x. What is x? We have been given the value of x is 2. So where is x there to our equation? We are going to insert this value. This one. This value. So So X here, what does X input to? 2. Then what is it now? Operations. And the price at the basic mathematics operation here. The next one is D. D. What is the value of D? The value of D is 4. So like here, 4. Then you put in brackets. Then we multiply by y. What is the value of y? The value of y is 1. So we multiply, we put 1 here. Then we multiply by 1. But y is square. We put this square. Then we divide by x. What is the value of x? The value of x is 2. We repeat again, write the value of x is 2 here. Then we minus 1 here. What next now? Then if I take 2 plus 4, we start to open the brackets according to what mass. 2 plus 4 times 1 square. We start with the brackets. So when you find the summation of 2 plus 4, we get 6. So k now is equal to 6, then times 1 square, then divide by 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1, this is equal to 1. So now, but 1 square? 1 square is equal to 1. So k now, this is equal to 6 times 1, then divide by 1. So the value of k, this is equal to 6. So this is the value of k, but we are required to turn the value of x. We have obtained the value of k. The value of k is 6. So k is equal to 6, but we are not required to turn the value of k. We are required to turn the value of x. Where can we obtain that is the value of x? Then we go back to this equation, which says that y squared, this is equal to k bracket x minus 1, then over x plus d. We start with that equation. So in order to turn the power of x, what are we going to do now? We are supposed to divide by k both sides. Divide by k both sides, and k will cancel. So now we make this y square over k. This is equal to x minus 1 over x plus d. Now, before proceeding with the answer, let us insert the values here. You're going to use the value given after the word defined. So to determine the value because the required value. So to determine the required value. So now we are going to find the value of x here. This is x. So we are supposed to determine the value of x. Before determining the value of x, let us insert the value again. So the value of y after the word defined. The value of y is equal to 2. So we are going to press 2 where there is y here. So instead of writing y, we write 2. 2, but what is square? Then divide by k. What is the value of k? The value of k we have already obtained, which is 6. Then divide by 6 here. This is equal to x plus 1, x minus 1 over x plus d. So what are we going to do now? After in there, 2 square. 2 square is equal to 4. So that is 4 over 6. This is equal to x minus 1 over x plus d. Therefore, in order to turn the power of x, we are supposed to cross in multiplication. Now we cross in multiplication. So now we cross in multiplication here. So start with this one. 4, make sure this 4 multiplies the denominator numbers or values. So you get 4 brackets x plus d, x plus d brackets. This is equal to 6. Make sure this is 6 multiplies the numerators. 6 brackets x minus d 1. But here we have left to see d, this one. So what is the value of d? The value of d is 1 here. We check it, then we're going to insert where this is d. So now 4 bracket x plus the value of d is 1 here. This one, 1. Then this is equal to 6 bracket x minus 1. Then we start to open the bracket. 4 times x, we get 4x. Then plus 4 times 1, we get 4. This is equal to 5, 6 minus 6 times x, get 6x. Then what is the next operation? Is minus at the basic mathematics operation. Therefore, 6 times 1, you get 6. After reaching to this point, now we just correct the similar terms. Then you take this one and minus this one. So when you take this one to this side, you get this side, you get 4 plus 6. This is equal to 6x minus 4x. 6 is this one, then we come, we descend to this side because the root symbol is 6x. So now, 4 plus 6 is getting 10. This is equal to 6x minus 4x is getting 2x. So now we are supposed to divide by 2, divide by 2. So now the value of x is, this is equal to 5. Let us see the third equation. Our third question is this: the time t days, so the time t and the days required to build a house is inversely proportional to the number of builders. N. This N represents number of builders, but this is T represents days of building the house. All are working the same rate. If there are 6 builders, it takes 8 days to complete the house. So how many builders must be employed to build the same house is just 16 days. So this is a simple question. This is a simple question. So now the first thing to do is to write the writing solution. After writing the writing solution, start to read the question again. A question says that time t days required to build a house is inversely proportional to the number of builders. So instead of writing days here, we use the value of t. So right now t. The time t, this one, means this t in term of days. T in term of days. T required to build a house is inversely proportional to the number of builders. Is inversely proportional. Inversely proportional. When you say inversely proportional, that you're going to write the direct proportional sign, but you put it 1 over. So here we put 1 over the number of builders. Number of builders is n. So it's divided by n here. So after that, keep on reading the question again. All are working the same rate. If there are 6 builders, it takes 8 days to complete the house. So how many builders must be employed to build the same house in just 16 days? So now, we have obtained, or we have realizing that there is not any data pointing to this in our questions. So now, let us remove this property 19 sign. So now, t, once we want to remove this property sign, we put equal sign with k. So put equal sign with k, then multiply by 1 over n. 1 over n. When we put 1 over n, we know that from mathematical jargon. Any number which is stand alone means it is divisible by 1. So we are going to divide here by 1. Therefore, t, this is equal to k times 1, you get k. 1 times n, you get n. This one. So we are going to multiply by n, so to multiply by n both sides. So n and n will cancel. So we make this k, this is equal to n times t, but we have the value of it. So now k, this is in order to determine the constant k, we are going to start with the value of n and time. So now we read the question again. The time t that is required to build the house is inversely proportional to the number of builders n. All working the same rate. If there are 60 builders, it takes 8 days to complete the house. So here we have, if there are 60 builders, this means the number of builders. So here, first at the end, we start to 60. So now, k is equal to 60. First at the end, we push this 6. Times t. T is in term of days. So we multiply by our time. Our time here will be 80. So multiply by 80 days. Now the value of k, this is equal to 480. So that is the value of constant k. But we require to determine the number of builders who must be building the same house. In just 16 days. So now, in order to get the number of builders, what you're going to do now? You're going to use this formula, the constant formula, this one. Or we can use this formula. Then we say from here, we are supposed to determine the value of number of builders. How we can obtain it? From here. Which is say that t, this is equal to k times 1 over n. So t now, this is equal to k over n. So the value of k we have, which is 480. So we take this one, then we press as k. Then we find this one, n. So how we can do now? So to determine the value of n. We are supposed to, maybe, even then we can finish it. So we can put here 1, then we cross in multiple. classification. What is our aim? Our aim is to make A from the subject because it's a value we are required to determine it. So now, theta is then get N T. This is equal to 1 times K is equal to K. Remember that we are required to times the number of builders which can build in the same house within 16 days. So now we are going to divide by T, result to divide by T both sides. So T and T cancel. So N now, this is equal to take the value of K. The value of K is 480. It is 480. Then you divide by T. What is our time? Our time is 16 days. So we divide by 16 days. So now, we're going to time the number of builders. So now say N, this is equal to 480, then divided by 16. Now start to simplify. When divided by 2 here, you get 8. When divided by 3, you get 240. When divided by 8 is 1, here is 30. So now, the number of builders, whose building the same house within 16 days are started. So this is the number of builders. Thank you for watching. God blessing you.